In this video, you will see why we need an expansion loop on long-run piping, even on the pipe rack or sleepers. Sometimes, fluids need to be transferred from the far side of the plant. We can't leave the long-run piping without restraints, especially since the lines contain high-temperature fluids in the low ambient temperature environment. The restraints on the long-run straight piping are crucial. However, due to thermal expansion and seismic events, the stoppers take excessive loads, making it impossible or expensive to design a special support. By the expansion loops, we can reduce the stopper's load by sharing. This will allow us to control the line better. The second reason for the expansion loop requirement is to minimize thermal expansion on the farthest side from the stoppers. This has two benefits. First, we don't need to consider the flexibility of branch connections, which could increase the cost if we have multiple branches. Second, if we use an expansion loop on the line, we don't need to worry about the length of the pipe shoes on the farthest side from the stoppers. The last one. Consider that two pipe racks are perpendicular to each other. If we put the pipe stopper to the natural zero point, the expansion on the corner will be formed like this. Any guide requirement here, due to the seismic effect, will contradict with this stopper. This is why it is important to use the expansion loop to manage expansion with the help of restraints. Without it, the piping system may collide with adjacent lines during normal operation and occasional conditions. Let's analyze the long-run pipe and expansion loop design on Caesar 2. Before we start, let's outline the input values in this example. Pipe diameter, 6 inches. Pipe thickness, schedule standard. Operating temperature, 200 degrees Celsius. Operating pressure, 20 bar. Ambient temperature, 0 degrees Celsius. This piping has 100 millimeters thick insulation. We have entered all of these input values. Initially, assuming both ends are anchored, let's analyze the loads at the anchor points. As seen, overstress occurs along the piping. The axial load at the anchor points is approximately 1.6 million newtons, and these forces act against each other, meaning they push against one another. Therefore, we cannot leave it as it is. Anchors are not very realistic for straight pipelines. When we remove the anchors, we can observe the expansions at the pipe ends due to thermal expansion. This analysis shows that stopping the line at the natural zero point will not impact the level of expansion. However, performing the analysis without considering the seismic rates would be incorrect. We also need to update our load cases. After conducting the analysis, we observe that the pipe ends undergo significant expansion movements under operating conditions. Additionally, the axial forces at seismic conditions are relatively higher, especially for long-run piping. Leaving these expansions as they would require additional expansion loops, especially in branch piping design. Therefore, designing an expansion loop on the main line is much more economical. Now, let's design a 5-meter expansion loop. The length of 5 meters is chosen solely because it aligns with the width of the existing pipe rack. There is no particular reason for this specific length. A longer expansion loop could be utilized, but it would necessitate additional steel structures. Therefore, an optimal design should be selected. After running this analysis, we see that the expansion loop has reduced the axial load on the previously anchored straight pipe to approximately 9,000 newtons. This demonstrates how much axial loads can be reduced using an expansion loop. Thus, a loop length of around 5 to 6 meters will be sufficient. We can reduce the operational loads on the stoppers by increasing the length of the expansion loop. When we do this extension, we should also check the deflection at the middle of the expansion loop's leg. Adding a node in the middle will make this more accurate. In our example, the deflection is 3.5 milliliters at sustained case, which is acceptable because it is less than 12.5 millimeters. The axial force during operational conditions is now reduced to 6,000 newtons. Before we continue, please push the like button and subscribe for more videos. Now, let's assume this pipeline continues over another pipe rack perpendicular to the existing one. In this case, if we don't use expansion loop on this type of long-run pipe rack, the expansion level at the turn will be high at operation, and the line will clash with the nearby piping lines. Also, if we use guides on the turn, the line will be subjected to overstress because the stoppers and guides contradict each other. In conclusion, the ideal solution is to design an expansion loop for each long-run pipe rack. This will give us the best control on the piping design. Finally, let's compare the hand calculation with our design. In our Caesar model, we designed the expansion loop with 6 meter long. Our expansion loop formula gives us 4.6 meter expansion loop. So, the 6 meter long expansion loop design is sufficient. If you liked the video, please push the like button and subscribe for more videos.